Hi you guys, it's Linnea. Today I'm going to be creating a fun card using the Seesaw Slider Die and the Pixie Pal stamp set from the LDRS Creative Spring 2020 release. And I'll be using some older products and then some of their new inks as well. So to start off with, I have the Rainy Day stencil. This stencil is so awesome for creating scenes, simple and intricate, whatever kind of scene you want to do, this is your stencil to do it. So I'm grabbing the Marina Madness Hybrid Ink. This is one of the new ink colors for the Spring 2020 collection. And I'm just going to blend off the top of that stencil to create a puffy cloud border. And you can see I used some masking tape there just so that I don't get any of the raindrops or the rain clouds. I just want to have a few layers of these puffy clouds going about halfway down my card. Now, once I was done with my clouds, I decided to blend some ink off the bottom of the stencil, and this is going to be the new Prickly Pear Perfection ink. I ended up covering this up. It worked better with my card design to use a die cut from In the Grass die set, but I wanted to keep this in here because I wanted to show you this Prickly Pear Perfection ink color. It's probably one of my favorites from these new hybrid ink collection. I think it's such a bright and happy green. It's super awesome. So here's my background that I have so far. And then to clean my stencil, I'm just going to be using some of the Extreme Clean Stamp Cleaner. And this is also from LDRS Creative. And this is the only ink cleaner that I've ever used that takes away the hybrid ink. Hybrid ink a lot of the time stains your stencils and your stamps, which is totally okay because the photopolymer is high quality, which means that it takes on the ink. But I'm kind of obsessive about my stamps and I like to keep them clean. And when Angie, the owner of the company, told me about this stamp cleaner, I immediately ordered some and I am obsessed with it. So definitely get yourself some of this Extreme Clean stamp cleaner because it certainly is extreme and it really does clean your stamps really, really well. Okay, so I have stamped out a bunch of images from the Pixie Pals stamp set. I've stamped out some of the flowers, a few of the fairies, three of the fairies. There are two other ones, I believe, that I didn't stamp and use. And I'm just going to color them in really simply. I've also stamped out some of those little mushroom houses, and I only ended up using one of them. So any of the extra images that I don't use, I'll just cut them out, and then I keep them in the back of the stamp pocket where I store my stamp set so that the next time I want to create a card, I already have some pieces already cut and ready to go. So once I'm done coloring these, I'm going to use the Pixie Pals die set and just cut all of them out so that I can move on to the next part of my card. And that is going to be die cutting and assembling the seesaw slider mechanism. So before I did any of that, I kind of wanted to just arrange where I thought I was going to have my characters on my scene. This is not exact. I'm just getting a basic idea because you're going to want to cut directly into your card front to create that seesaw slider mechanism. So once I have a basic idea, I'm going to start with this little, it kind of reminds me of a bench piece, so that's what I call it, is the bench die. And I'm going to line this up. You want this not directly in the center of your card. And I'm going to show you why in a minute here. The actual seesaw slider, like this big wonky piece that I'll pull into the screen in just a minute, is going to need to have enough room for this top arm to swing back and forth. So I need to move this die set down just a little bit. There is a little hole in the center of both of those dies, and those are going to line up with a brad, and you'll see that in a minute. But I needed to make sure that that top arm has enough room to swing back and forth. Okay, so I've die cut all of my pieces for the mechanism from white cardstock. There are circle pieces and footballs or oval pieces. The oval pieces have a score line down the middle, so I just folded two of those footballs in half, and then I kind of nestled them into the slider track. I'll zoom in here so you can see a little bit better. I'm going to nudge these two, the flat edges where I folded in half, nudge them together, and then you're going to want to put something, either a circle or another oval on top. And you can use liquid glue, whatever you want to use. I found that a medium-sized Zot works perfectly here. And it was less messy than liquid glue and easier for me to work with. So I added that zat on there, and then I'm going to hold them so that they are tight. You want to make sure that they are butted right up against each other. And then I put a circle on top. I'm going to do the same thing on the back. I ended up doing circles on the front and a football on the back, but you could do whatever you want. I went with circles because my images that I'm going to be adding on top of this mechanism are small, so I want to be able to trim away some of the edges of this little slider mechanism here. I repeated the same thing on the other side, and now you can see here I have two pieces that freely slide up and down, and so this is the start of the seesaw mechanism. Now we're going to be working with that wonky, I just call it the wonky piece. So I have a brad. I lined up the little circle that's in the front of the card front, and I put that right through the wonky die here. Now you want to make sure when you're using the brad that you don't flatten it down completely. If you do, this isn't going to have a lot of room to move around. So I kind of have a little extra space in between the arms of the brad. Now you want to move one of those slider pieces all the way to the top of a track and the other one all the way to the bottom of the track. This is going to give you the seesaw mechanism. So when you pull the arm, the one that's at the top will move down and the one that's at the bottom will move up. I'm adding a foam square. You could use a foam circle. In the center of the notch that's cut out from that wonky die piece, and then I'm adding a football on top just to kind of seal that together. And now you can see here on the front when one moves up, the other moves down, and it's just so, so fun. Okay, so these rectangle pieces here are stabilizer pieces for the pull tab arm, and there are four score lines, so I'm just going to fold on all four of those, and that's going to form a like a 3D rectangle. Now this is the pull tab here. There is an X marked on the front of this, and that is where you want to line that up with the arm or the wonky die piece. And we're going to add another foam piece right onto, almost like we did with the footballs before, to start forming this mechanism. You'll see that in a minute here. Right now, I'm just lining up where I want the pull tab arm to come out on the side of my card. And then I'm going to add these stabilizer pieces in place. I put one all the way over to the right side, and then another one a little bit further. I like to use two. You only have to use one, but I like to use two just to make sure that arm stays straight. I slid that pull tab through, and then there you could see I added a foam square in that little notch, and then a football piece on top of that, just like we did before. And that's the pull tab mechanism. Now, if you find that anything is sticking, I like to use a little bit of powder tool in those tracks, and that just decreases the friction and allows the pull tab to pull, and then the slider on the seesaw mechanism just to slide a little bit better. So my whole time, I'm just checking to make sure that nothing is interfering with each other, and as long as everything is good to go, you're now okay to start working on the front of your card. So here's where I replaced my grass that I had stenciled at the bottom with a die cut. And this is from the In the Grass dies. I just created this little grassy hill border. And then I popped up that border with a double layer of foam tape. Anything that I add to the front of my card, I want to make sure it's not going to interfere with those slider channels or with the brad that's in the center of the card. The brad needs to be able to move a little bit. So as I'm adhering all my elements on top, I'm going to make sure that nothing is in the way of any of those mechanisms. Now, in addition, when you are fully assembling your card, everything's done on the front now, you want to add a double layer of foam tape to the back, but also you need to make sure this foam tape doesn't interfere with any of the moving parts of the die. And that's it. That completes my card. I hope that you enjoyed this little look at the seesaw slider die. It's such a fun way to create an interactive card. I'll see you guys later. Bye.